Now, from the last record that I made with Pink Floyd, which was called The Final Cut, and it was back in 1982, can you believe it? I can. We're going to do the last track on The Final Cut, which is a song called Two Suns in the Sunset. And it's an appropriate song at the moment because it's about a bloke who's going home in his van one night to see his wife and his kids and blah, blah. And the Third World War happens. And so he looks at it and he thinks, fuck me, and then he burns to a crisp. And so does everybody else in the world. And not just us, all the little furry animals and all the trees and everything is gone. And this, if that happens, will be just a barren piece of rock in the cold out there. So, might it not be a really, really good idea if we could prevent that particular thing happening by getting rid of all the nuclear weapons on Earth? Yes, it would be. So, if you want ever run into one of our leaders, those politicians who organise our lives for us, you might just give whoever it might be. I've no idea who runs Denmark. And I mean, I know I should know, but it's very difficult to keep up because the fucking politicians change every 5 minutes and you've no idea who's in charge of anything. But I'm not singling out Denmark, obviously. This is true all over the world. But why, if you do run into one, say, oi, Gustav, or whatever the name might be, why don't you go down the bar and have a word with Biden and Putin and who and blah, blah, blah. I've no idea who they are in England anymore, because I don't live there. And they change every afternoon after lunch, when everyone had a nice lunch in the Houses of Parliament. So it's this bloke looking down. He's thinking, what the fuck is he talking about? And I have a lot of sympathy for it. Anyway, so they should all go down the bar and say, well, yeah, it is insane that we have thousands of nuclear weapons. And we've had nuclear weapons since 1945. They've only been used in anger once, and that was twice on the Japanese at Nagasaki and Hiroshima. And they were tiny ones. They were like bloody ping pong balls compared with what they've got now. So why don't they, and they could get together and say, they're very expensive, let's get rid of them, shall we? And we could spend the money on, maybe a health service, or, you know, looking after the homeless black lady, for instance, or something like that. Or education for our children. What about free education for everybody? And if they weren't lying to you, quite a lot of them would go, actually, we make a lot of money out of making them and keeping them. So we're going to keep them. Yeah, but they're unbearably dangerous, you silly bastard. Get rid of them. And they might be able to persuade it. The ones who don't want to, that it's a really good idea. Like, you can tell them if you ever meet one of these people, when you're down the pub talking to the others, tell them Roger said it's a really good idea that you describe. Anyway, listen, you may say ban the bomb. I've been banning the bloody bomb since I was 15 years old. I was the chairman of the Youth Campaign for Nuclear Disarmament in Cambridge in England 64 years ago, for fuck's sake. I've been at this a long time. And I've had no success at all yet. But the time has come. It is insane that we still have these things on the plane. I'm going to go and get another drink of water because my whistle is a bit dry. And then I'm going to sing this song for you. But before I do, go and get my slug of water. Thank you so much for coming tonight. It's been a huge pleasure for me and the Boys and Girls on stage. I love you too, obviously, or I wouldn't be here, you know, on a Tuesday night. I'd probably be down the pub playing darts or something. I can't think of anywhere in the world that I would rather be right now than here with you lot, because you've been a fantastic audience. I did have one other thing to say, and that was, and this is, I will get to the point in a minute. Back in 1947, a committee of atomic scientists got together and they invented this concept that they called the doomsday clock, and it's got a ticking hand. And the idea is it's to frighten people, because they say the clock is ticking, and when it hits midnight, we're all gone, all of us, and all our uncles and aunts and children and all that, the doomsday clock. Okay, and they reset the time every year, and things are more dangerous now, according to them, than they have ever been. They reset the doomsday clock this year. Last year it was 100 seconds to midnight, this year it's 90. So, give that some thought. When I stamp my foot, miraculously, the doomsday clock will start ticking.
Could be the to you.